Good morning.
Good morning.
Last week we were talking about how movement can help stimulate your brain in ways that helps with memory, helps with happiness, mm-hmm. helps, But I think more importantly is you should try to find ways to move in a novel way, like a new way. And so I wanted to give you guys some ideas for different things you can do, challenges, you might want to call it, that make you move differently than maybe what you typically do. Now, if you're a dancer out there, maybe you do this already. But if you're not a dancer, here are some good ones. So do you have anything, or do you want me to start?
Well, I was just thinking that made me think about how, you know how everyone has, like, oh, I have tight hamstrings, or uh-huh. I have really tight hip flexors. Uh-huh. And maybe that, instead of, like, going away from it, kind of this week, kind of focusing on going into those areas that are more challenging.
Like not avoiding, not just accepting that you have tight hamstrings, but
like spend 5 days just being like, I want to, every day I'm going to hit this with some activities.
Okay, so here are some ones from shoulders and down. Okay, you guys roll your shoulders back. Now roll your shoulders forward. Now make one go forward and one go back. Is that hard?
Oh, I was trying. I thought about it a different way.
Let's do the rib one that you do.
Okay. So put your hands on your hips. Hips don't move. Now just move the rib cage. And now put your hands on your rib cage. Don't move the rib cage and just move the hips. And then putting that together, can you move them in opposite directions? And then that turns into staying alive. But that's tricky because you go.
Alright. One more. Down to your feet. It's like one heel and one toe turns goes